I am Chen Laoshi from Mandarin community. 好，我们今天来学习快递。
Okay, so today we're going to talk about Kuaidi Delivery.
对啊。
This is a very irritating thing, I think, for foreigners in China.
对中国人也是一样的。
Oh, so it's irritating for Chinese people too.
对啊，比如说啊，这个，但是我们要先在这个遇到问题之前，最好把问题都解决了，对不对？
Okay, so before there's a problem, we should prevent it.
对的，所以第一个啊，第一个就是很多外国人在用淘宝的时候，
yeah.
有时候出现问题是因为他们的地址写的不对。
Oh, so a lot of foreigners, when they use Taobao to get deliveries, one of the big problems they have is that their address is wrong.
对，因为我有很多学生啊，他们有时候说，老师，我的快递不见了，怎么怎么，但是最后发现是地址就是错的。
他们地址怎么是错的？
因为外国人可能是租房子，你知道吗？
Yeah.
因为有的时候这个学生不清楚这个地址到底是什么，因为上海有很多弄啊，门牌号啊，这个南门、
yeah.
北门啊，小区很大呀，有很多问题。对，
okay.
所以呢，我有一个学生啊，他去问保安说的也不清楚，所以我们一起改了三次地址都没有改对。
Okay.
嗯。
Yeah.
啊、
so, addresses.In Shanghai can be a little bit complicated because we have, you know, there's like the street, then there's a nong, and then there's the building number and all this other stuff. So you have to make sure that you get it all right.
对，所以最好的方法是让你的房东给你一个正确的地址。
Yeah, so you, the best way to do it is to make your landlord give you the full and complete address.
对的啊，因为房东有一个那个房产证。
Yeah, yeah.
对吧？上面的地址一定是对的。
Right, okay. So the address that the landlord uses should be the one from his property deed.
对，对，
yeah.
对。所以第一步啊，你要确定你的地址是对的。
Okay.
对吧？然后第二，就是你在选择地址的时候，不要选错了啊，因为你可能有很多个不一样的地方。
Oh, okay. So when you input the address, there is...like a drop-down menu? Oh, okay. So when you put in the address, you have to make sure that you pick the right one.
对，比如说你是想要这个快递送到你的家，还是送到你的公司？
Oh, right. Because you can put in more than one address. So you can put, like, I have this. You can put your address, like your work address, or your home address, or, I don't know, maybe a friend's house or something. And so you have to make sure that you pay attention and pick the right one.
对啊，好的。所以第一步啊，你自己选对那个地址很重要啊。
Yeah, okay.
好，然后第二个啊，第二个，因为很多外国人啊，他们工作，所以不在家，这是一个问题，对吗？
Yep.
嗯，好。
Yeah, so one problem also is when, if you are at work, and the guy...
你的快递要去家里，对吧？
Right, and the Kuaidi is going to go to your house.
好，所以这个时候啊，我们有这个东西，你们知道吗？
自提柜。
对。
Oh, yeah, yeah, the like the self-pickup. Boxes.
对，所以一般来说，小区里面都会有。
Yeah, so lots of 小区 like the compounds, the neighborhoods have these boxes now.
对，所以我建议啊，如果这个外国人在住在那个上海的这个家里啊，
yeah.
你可以先去找一找你家附近的这个在哪里。
Okay.
对，因为如果你知道了在哪里，就很方便。
Okay.
因为如果你的那个快递今天会送来，因为你可以看到那个。
Yeah.
你的信息对吧
？Right.
你可以先给师傅打电话，然后告诉他我不在家，你放在自提柜里。
Okay.
嗯。
So what Chen Laoshi is saying is because in Taobao you can look up the basically like the path of delivery and you can see when you're going to receive your package and so. If you check and you see it's going to come tomorrow and you're going to be at work, then you can call the delivery guy ahead of time. This information is all in the app.
Right.
You can call ahead of time and tell him to, say again,
放在自提柜里.
Yeah, put it in the self-pickup box.
对的，你说我不在家，我不在家。
Yeah, you tell him that you're not going to be home and to put it there.
对，就可以了。
Right.
对吧？
Yeah.
明白啊。
明白。
好，然后呢，但是啊，做这件事情的时候你要注意，你要知道这个。
Yeah.
这个啊，就这个部分，因为你每次啊，在淘宝里面，如果你买了一个东西，它会有一个订单号。
What do I need this for?
因为你要告诉他们你的。
Oh, you mean when you call the delivery guy? Okay.
对。
Yeah.
明白。
Okay, yeah. So when you call the delivery guy, you have to be able to tell him your 订单号, the order number.
对的。 好，但是啊，
yeah.
但是如果你觉得给快递的师傅打电话，他们可能听不懂，对吧？
Yeah.
你可以给快递公司，因为一般来说啊，一般来说这个如果啊，如果你看到你的那个快递是这个派件中，
派件中
就是
in the process of being delivered, like
对的
soon, yeah, basically soon to arrive.
好，一般来说出现这个三个字的时候，它有两个电话号码。
Okay.
一个是手机号码，很清楚，比如137158。
Yeah.
好，第二个号码是这个，第二个号码是021，然后巴拉巴拉巴拉。
Okay, so when you open up your Taobao app and you see this 派件中, meaning that the package is en route, then there will be two phone numbers there. And if, because the problem is a lot of these Kuaidi delivery guys are, they don't speak Mandarin very well. And a lot of them are not very patient. They don't want to listen to you. They will interrupt and they're very hard to communicate with, actually. So if you're afraid of having that problem, then you can also call the Kuaidi company, which is, so there will be two phone numbers, and one of them will start with 021, blah, 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 blah. This is a Shanghai area code for like a landline, basically. So that'll be the company, and you can call them and talk to a service person who will speak Mandarin well and be more patient and have a better attitude. So you can tell them to have the guy, the 师傅放在字体柜里。
然后呢，你就告诉他们，他们就会问你，你好，你的订单号是什么？
Yeah, so they'll ask you what your 订单号 is, your order number. So you have to have your app open and you can check.
对，然后你告诉他巴拉巴拉巴拉 the series of number, right?
Yeah, you tell them.
然后他们就会说，好的，好的，对吧？然后你告诉他我不在家，你告诉师傅放在字体柜里。
Yeah.Okay, and yes, so you can just, after you give them the ding dan hao, your order number, then you can tell them to please, 你帮我告诉那个师傅，我不
在
家，放在字体柜里，
就好了。
Yeah, I won't be at home, please put it in the self-pickup box. Make sure you know where your self-pickup box is.
对，只要知道你家在哪里，但是我家，我的家和我爸爸妈妈的家都在小区里面。
Yeah.
非常方便。
Yeah, yeah. Most 小区, most compounds will have this pickup box now.
明白了啊。好，但是啊，但是你要看到了这个啊，看到派件中你在做这个事情啊。
Yeah.
你做太早也没有用，
right.
还没到呢啊。
That's true. Okay. So yeah, you have to wait until the status of your package is 派件中, like en route. Before you make this phone call. Otherwise, if you call too early, then it's just, it's not, nobody's going to remember.
对, 对, 他们说这个东西还没到。
Yeah, yeah.
对啊。
So you have to wait until then.
明白了啊。好的，所以订单号很重要啊。
Yeah, the 订单号 is important. Your order number.
对，第二个是这三个字啊，派件中。
派件中。
在这个时候你就可以给快递公司或者是给师傅打电话了。
Yeah.
这个时候最有用。
When it's 派件中 en route, then you can call the Kuaidi company or the delivery guy.
好的啊，好，那再来一个。那如果啊，如果你的快递真的不见了。
Yeah, and what if it really,
yeah,
if you can't find it, that happens to me a lot.
对，因为有可能有时候是这个地址不对，师傅找不到你，他给你打电话你没接，明白吗？
Yep.
对，那这个时候师傅会把你的快递放回那个这个地方。驿站，驿站就是那个快递来了以后，比如说在静安区，你的那个小区有一快递，对吧？
Yeah.
就所有的那里的东西都在那里。
Oh, I didn't know that. Okay, so what would you call that? It's
the, 就是一个 transfer station,
package transfer station.
对，所以在那里有所有的快递。
Okay, so if, I mean, I have, anyway, if the delivery guy brings it to your house, you're not there, there's no 字体柜, then he will allegedly take your package back to the transfer facility, the 驿站字体, and then you have to go there and get it yourself.
对的。
That's never happened to me.
对，就是这个不常见啊。
Yeah, what happens is they put the Kuaidi somewhere weird, and then you can't find it.
但是一般来说啊，一般来说，如果师傅不可以给你，
yeah.
他就放回去。
That's never happened to me. They always, they always call screaming, like mad that you're not home, right? And then you just tell them, okay, put it outside the front door.
对，我觉得你可能不知道有这个。
Yeah, I didn't know there was that.
但是一般来说啊，因为这个师傅他们送快递，这个是他们的工作，对吧？
Right.
所以他们的这个工作流程就是送过去，你不在，拿过去。
Really? So are they not supposed to put the Kuaidi like at your door?
对，除非啊，可以的，就除非啊，除非是他送错地方了。
Yeah, that does happen sometimes. Yeah, I've had people steal my packages before.
对, 有的啊。那如果是谁 steal 你的 package, 这个就没办法了。
Yeah, no, the Kuaidi company will take responsibility for it.
是是是，但是我的意思是如果那个人很坏啊，他拿了你的快递，那就这个师傅也不可以帮你的，对吧？
Yeah, that's...
好，那我昨天啊，我昨天还是前天啊，有一个学生，他就是那个地址写错了，
okay.
然后师傅把他的东西送到了错的地方，
yeah.
对吧？但是呢，那个送去错的地方以后呢，也没有人拿，就一直放在那里，
oh.
放在那里。然后呢，我帮这个学生打电话，问这个快递公司，打的是快递公司的电话，
yeah.
然后呢，这个快递公司就说好的，我们帮你找。他就去给这个师傅打电话，然后告诉师傅到原来的地方去把这个拿回来，
yeah.
然后再送到新的地方。
Oh, okay. So Chen Laoshi had a student the other day who had a package that they couldn't find, and so Chen Laoshi helped the student call the Kuaidi company, and it turned out that the address was written incorrectly, and so the shifu, the delivery guy, had put the package at somebody else's house. These people, they didn't take the package, they just left it there, so the guy went back and picked it up and then brought it back to the right place. Yeah.
对，所以你要注意，你在写地址的时候千万不要写错啊，
yeah.
因为这个学生他的家是530吧，他写了510吧。
Oh, yeah, the apartment number was wrong. Okay,
对,
yeah.
明白了吗?
So, okay. All right, yeah, let's go over some of these phrases, because I think the big problem for foreigners is when these Kuaidi guys call us up. And they're screaming at you. I mean, they always have to yell. They're, I don't know what's with that, but they're always like mad. And they never speak.
这个我真的不可以帮你，因为我自己都听不懂。
They never speak like slowly and clearly, and they're always angry and they're kind of scary.
对，但是啊，但是我如果在淘宝上买东西，
yeah.
我会看很清楚，没有一个地方是错的。因为如果快递师傅真的跟我说啊，我真的听不懂。
Yeah.
对他们跟我来来来来，我听不懂。对，如果我啊，我说你说慢一点。
Why do they do that? Why are they so?
因为他们说的不是普通话呀，你怎么可能听懂？
Okay, so yeah, they really, like, it's not necessarily that, you know, your Chinese is so bad, it's that most of them really are just not at all even trying to speak Mandarin.
对啊，因为他们的这个 Mandarin 就是有口音的。
Yeah.
他们的 Mandarin 跟我们的 Mandarin 是完全不一样的。
Yeah, their Mandarin, or their Mandarin is just really crappy.
对啊，比如说啊，比如说我如果一个师傅给我打电话，
yeah.
对吧？我如果我说你说慢一点，你再说一次，没有用，他说十次我也听不懂。
Okay, so you can try to ask them, like, 说慢一点, slow down, or 再说一遍, please say it again, and see if that helps, but maybe not.
绝对不能, 对。
Yeah.
所以我的建议啊, 有问题不要找师傅, 找快递公司。
Okay, so Chen Laoshi's suggestion is instead of dealing with the shifu, the delivery guy, then just call the Kuaidi company. You'll get some nice, polite lady on the phone who speaks clear Mandarin and will be patient with you.
对, 那可能有时候他们还可以说英文。
Yeah, sometimes. I don't know. I will...
好的，但是啊，但是还有一个，我觉得很多外国人不知道这个 APP.
Okay, so there's an app that Chen Laoshi thinks that most foreigners don't know about. I don't know about this app, so...
好，这个菜鸟果果和淘宝是一起的，但是我不知道为什么外国人都不知道这个。
Okay, so what is this app?
这个就是看你的那个快递在哪里的，非常非常详细。因为它跟淘宝是一样的，你知道吗？
Really?
所以一般来说，在淘宝上买了那个东西以后，我可以打开这个 APP， 然后在里面它会很详细的告诉你，
就是你淘宝里面的
是一样的，
什么消息都会出现在这个，
就是快递的消息。对
，OK。
这个啊，比如说，如果你要放在这个字体柜里，对吧？
Yeah.
或者有时候师傅看到你不在家，他会自己放在字体柜里。
OK。
然后你的那个什么来着？密码。
Yeah.
你要去拿这个东西的密码，对吧？
Yeah, they send a text message. Okay, okay. Oh, okay, so there's an app called 菜鸟果果, like 菜鸟 package,
对,
that is linked to Taobao. And if you have this app and you set it up, then you can log in and look at your Kuaidi information.
对,
and if the 师傅 puts it in the 字体柜, then the 密码, the password will show up in this app.
对的，因为在淘宝你看不到啊。就比如说啊，比如说那个我前几天那个学生对吧，他遇到那个问题是因为他的地址是错的，
yeah.
所以他其实所有的快递都在这里，
Oh, the, all of their packages were
out. 对，但是因为他不知道有这个 APP。
Yeah。
但是在这个 APP 里面给了他很多很多的消息，说请你到这个驿站去拿，然后他也给了你这个驿站的地址，给了你去拿这个东西的密码都有。
Oh, okay.
但是只是因为他不知道有这么一个 APP。
So can you 这个 APP 你能不能用它跟那个师傅沟通，就是在 APP 里面发信息什么的？
不，他只是给你看的，然后给你发密码，给你发什么东西的啊
？OK。
对，但是呢，这个上面也会告诉你这个师傅的电话和快递公司的电话。
Yeah. Okay. So I don't know. I mean, one way that I kind of deal with this problem is I never call the Kuaidi guys and.If they call me screaming and I can't understand them, then I will text them because I can read what they write better than I can understand their crappy Mandarin.
对的，对的。
Yeah.
但是我觉得你们外国人啊，可以下载这个。有了这个以后，我觉得方便很多。
I didn't know that. Okay, so Chen Laoshi thinks we should all of us foreigners should download this app.
对的。
And then you can get all of your package information and updates and everything there.
对，就是如果啊，如果你用淘宝的话，就下载这个。
Yeah. Okay. So这个 APP 跟淘宝就会连起来。
连起来，对的。
Okay. So they'll be linked together these two.
对，但是淘宝上的那个快递的信息没有那么清楚。
Yeah, that's
true.
Okay. So the package information that you can find in Taobao is not as clear and detailed is what you can find in this app. Cool. Yeah, I didn't know that.
对，所以啊，如果这个师傅他把你的那个快递真的还回去了，你没有收到，他放回这里的话啊，在这个上面都会告诉你。
Oh, okay.
然后你就拿着那个，你就打开这个信息，然后它上面会有一个密码，你就地址也会告诉你。
Okay.
就是你家旁边的这个驿站在哪里。
Okay.
所以你拿着你的手机，然后拿着就打开这个，然后去那个地方，然后给他们看。
Oh, okay. So this app will give you like the address of the 驿站and the 密码 that you need to pick up your package, and you can just take that over to the 驿站, the transfer station, show it to somebody, and they'll just give you your packages.
对的，对的。明白。因为其实你的家附近肯定有这个。
Yeah.
因为
我看过好多。
对对对，因为前几天那个学生他也说他每天都路过那个很多那个快递的那个地方，他说我就是不知道我的快递都在哪里，因为他自己的地址写错了嘛，对吧？
Yeah.
明白了啊。
Okay.
对，然后昨天还是前天我忘了啊。然后我让他下载这个，然后上面有几十条信息，每天都提醒他，请你来拿快递，请你来拿快递。对，但是因为他没有这个 APP， 所以他不知道。
Yeah. Interesting.
嗯嗯嗯。
Okay. Yeah.
明白了啊。
I mean, dealing with these Kuaidi guys is really like, I mean, they can be just so rude sometimes.
对对对。好，然后还有一个问题啊，最后一个问题啊。这个放在门口对吧、
嗯、
因为现在有很多快递他们也会像你说的别人偷了你的、
yeah.
丢了对吧、
yeah.
所以这个快递师傅他们不敢、
yeah.
放在门口明白吗好但是呢如果你的家啊就是不是你的家不是有楼吗、
yeah.
就如果这个师傅可以进去这个楼然后呢他就放在你的门口你觉得这个是安全的、
yeah.
就是你的楼里面不会有别人来拿你的快递、
okay.
你可以告诉师傅放在门口
I see、
嗯、
so If, oh, what was I going to say? All right, never mind, I forgot.
对，就是师傅他不敢把这个快递放在这个楼的外
面。Oh, right, because if, 这个师傅他如果是把东西放在你门口然后被别人拿走的话他是不是自己会被扣钱的
会啊他要负责任的你知道吗
so,
所以除非你跟师傅说如果这个快递真的丢了我不找你。
Okay, so, this, A lot of the shifus, the delivery guys, they don't want to put stuff at the door if you're not home. And the reason is because if somebody else takes it or it goes missing, then they will get charged for it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
对，所以他们不敢。
Yeah, I've never had that problem.
是的，对。然后呢，还有一个啊，就是因为如果他进了你的那个大楼，
yeah.
他可能更安全一样。比如说你的邻居，他可能不会来拿你的东西。
Yeah.
那这个时候可能有的人会告诉师傅没关系你放在那里吧不会丢的、
yeah.
对但是如果这个师傅他都不能进那个大楼他要放在那个楼的外面他不敢
Oh I see So if the 师傅 can go into your building up right to your apartment door then maybe they're more willing to just leave it there especially if you live on a floor whereyou know, maybe not so many other apartments or, you know, like your entrance is kind of hidden away a little bit. But if he has to put it like downstairs in a big pile at the main gate or something, then they're maybe not so willing. I think, 好像现在很多小区都已经不这样做了。
对，
都这个送快递送外卖的都可以进去。
对啊对啊，所以他现在不可以做了吧，对吧？明白吗？
Yeah.
对，所以因为他不敢啊，如果所以说你可以告诉师傅，你就放在这个字体柜里面。
Yeah.
因为字体柜里面你别人没有密码，不可以打开，
right.
所以
这个很安全。Yeah. So yeah, and if you're not home and they call you and they don't want to leave the package at your door, then you can just ask them to put it in that 字体柜。
对，对，但是我觉得最重要的还是可以先用这个礼品。
Yeah.
这个菜鸟裹裹的。
Okay.
嗯。
Sounds good.
对，明白吗？
Yeah.
对，那还有最后一个最重要的就是，如果真的有问题，可以找快递公司啊，
yeah.
因为他们至少他们说的是普通话。
Yeah, so if you really have a problem, like you lose your package or you can't talk to the Kuaidi guy, then just call the Kuaidi company because at the very least they speak Mandarin.
对对的。
Yeah.
明白吗？
明白。
对，好的啊。那当然就是还有一个问题啊，就是这个派件中的时候啊，你可以跟快递公司沟通，对吧？
嗯。
然后比如说你给他们打电话，你说，比如说你想要改一下那个送快递的时间都可以。
Oh, you can also during like 派件。派件中 when your package is en route, you can call the Kuaidi company and you can actually have them change the delivery time. So if the guy is like on his way and you're still at work or something, you can call them and ask to come a little bit later. These Kuaidi delivery guys, though, sometimes they deliver stuff until like 9 or 10 p.m. sometimes, I think.
对啊，所以这个时候你可以提前跟快递公司说，你可以跟他说，比如说啊，比如说你的那个 APP 啊，比如说这个菜鸟裹裹告诉你，哎，派件中。对吧？你要多注意看这个信息。
Yeah. 那这个 APP 里面会有一个具体的时间吗？
有时候有。
哦、oh, so ，
但是这个时间有点长。
Okay.
比如说从2点到10点。
哦、oh, ，I see。
有点长啊。
Okay.
啊，但是如果你看到了这个，对吧？
Yeah.
或者是你一大早就看到派件中，但是还没有显示时间的时候，
yeah.
你可以跟他们去预定一个时间。
Yeah, okay.
不要跟师傅说啊，跟快递公司。
Yeah, don't talk to the 师傅. I mean, I think we all know by now that is a complete waste of time.
对，
so、
因为啊。
Yeah, you can call the company and have them book a time for delivery.
对的，因为这个快递公司去通知师傅，这个师傅是工作的呀。
Yeah.
所以他会听他们的。
Yeah, so when the company notifies the 师傅 about a specific delivery time, then he has to listen because that's his boss, basically.
对
啊。Yeah.
明白吗？
对，
yeah. 但是我觉得如果你真的害怕你的这个快递不见了或者怎么样的，你就可以跟快递公司说啊，我今天早上不在家，你可以比如说晚上6点左右送到。
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, you can request that they come after you are home from work or whatever.
对。
Yeah. Okay.
明白吗？
明白。
好的，但是我觉得你可以先试一下用这个。
Yeah. Try the app.
对。
And also.
喜欢吗？喜欢吗？给我点赞，点赞。
Yeah, if you like our, if you like our video, give us a like and follow our channel on Youku or YouTube.
好的。
Okay.
好，下期见吧。
All right,
bye
bye.